This new American space capability can profoundly affect our security. In fact, if we use this new capability well, we can avoid passing on to our children and our grandchildren the sorry legacy of a balance of terror and mutual assured destruction theories, those theories which have dominated U.S. strategic thinking for nearly 20 years.
High frontier concepts developed by General Daniel Graham and his team of consultants and advisors is attracting serious attention from space enthusiasts. One of these is author Robert Heinlein.
The thing I like best about the high frontier, two aspects of it. One is it's non-nuclear, which should quiet down the people who go straight through the roof anytime anyone mentions the word nuclear. And the other is that there is nothing about any aspect of high frontier that constitutes an attack on anyone else. It's physically impossible to use any one of the concepts in high frontier for attack, for aggression. It is, for the first time, defense. We've been sitting here in the United States, fat, dumb, and happy for 40 years, telling ourselves we had defense because we had a Department of Defense, when in fact we had no defense at all. We have no means of stopping an ICBM. We didn't even have proposals for means until High Frontier came along. You can't kill a single Russian with High Frontier. What you can do is save the lives of American citizens, of the citizens of Western Europe, of the people of the Third World, and of Russians themselves, by quenching out a nuclear war even after the button is pushed.
April 14th, 1981, a spaceship landed on planet Earth. It was ours. When most Americans learn of the high frontier strategy of assured survival, they ask, why is it not already in effect? It is because our leaders need broad public support to change national policy. Because high frontier challenges those within the government bureaucracy who see a real strategy change as a threat to their vested interests. And because many Americans unfortunately prefer to cling to the vain hope that our security can best be guaranteed merely by agreements with the Soviets. The high frontier concept is based on existing technological capabilities. It is far less expensive than other methods of ensuring our security. High frontier's commercial space proposals will more than pay for the military systems. And best of all, it will relieve us of the balance of terror doctrines of the past. Some concerned Americans have already donated so that the high frontier team of scientists, engineers, and strategists could be assembled. We need your help to build public support to make High Frontier a reality. Call the toll-free number with your pledge or write to us at High Frontier, 1010 Vermont Avenue Northwest, Washington, D.C., 20005. Join us in this crucial effort.